George Eliot wrote quite eloquently, "What greater is for two human souls than to feel that they're joined for life, to strengthen each other in all labor, to rest on each other in all sorrow, to minister to each other in all pain, to be one with each other in silent, unspeakable memories at the last party."
A man stands now where our baby used to be, and the sight of him all grown up moves us. Our son has become a wiser, stronger man than we ever dreamed he could be. And we love you, Phil, and we are so proud of you today, and we are so happy that Laura has come into our lives and into our family, and I wouldn't have had it any other way. We love you, Laura.
I, Philip, take you, Laura, to be my wife.
I, Laura, take you, Phil, to be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
Holy Father, you created mankind in your own image, made man and woman to be joined as a husband and wife in union of body and heart, and so fulfill their mission in this world. Father, to reveal the plan of your love, you made the union of husband and wife an image of the covenant between you and your people. In the fulfillment of this sacrament, the marriage of Christian man and woman is a sign of the marriage between Christ and the Church. Father, stretch out your hand and bless Laura and Philip. Today, Lord, grant that as they begin to live this sacrament today, they may share with each other the gift of your love and become one in heart and mind as witnesses to your presence in their marriage.
And lastly for me, I'd like to thank Laura. As Erzio Severo said today, her hard work and determination is what you see today. I mean, this place looks amazing. We all know that it was all her. And this day turned out perfect. Laura, you are my rock, you are my constant, and I will love you forever.